Here in the boxing venue, the American fighters have yet to lose. And Paul Gonzalez, the light flyweight, in just a couple of moments, will be seeking the United States' 15th consecutive victory. But there is a problem, a controversy. Big breaking story today in the Washington Post to the effect that three members of the U.S. team, Mark Breland, Frank Tate, and Steve McCrory, have revolted against head coach Pat Nappy. They are quoted specifically as derogating his training methods and his leadership. Now, that story will further unfold in a talk I had just moments ago with a highly emotional head coach, Pat Nappy himself. Pat, your boxing team, the U.S. Olympic boxing team, has recorded 13 victories and a 14th by walkover. So you are 14-0. Nonetheless, you're under fire. Michael Wilbon, responsible reporter for the Washington Post, printed an article quoting Mark Breland, Frank Tate, and Steve McCrory as saying they're dissatisfied with your training methods and dissatisfied with your advice from the corner. You almost left town over this. You shocked by this?
Well, yes, I was really shocked by it, Howard. I mean, the damage was done. According to the papers, they've said it. Yet this morning, they came to me and apologized for everything that they did. And Mark even says that he was, kind of caught in between and didn't realize that he was caught there.
But why would they have done this, in your opinion?
Well, I think I don't believe the kids are at fault. I believe that the outside influence is the one that are putting pressure on these kids.
And, specifically, you mean Emanuel Stewart, the professional boxing manager and trainer, who is the chief operator of the Kronk Gym in Detroit.
Well, that's where they tell me it's coming from, Howard, yes.
As a matter of fact, Emanuel Stewart, at the Olympic trials and at the box off, worked in many fighters' corners, didn't he?
Yes, he did. Yes, he did. And at that particular time, he was allowed. But here, we have Olympic rules that we have to go by, and I don't set the rules down. The Olympic Committee sets these rules down, and we go by what the Olympic Committee says.
You referred to the U.S. Olympic Committee.
Yes.
It is a fact that people like Willie DeWitt of Canada and people in other countries do go to outside gyms and train with their respective trainers, isn't it?
Yes, and our kids, and those three in particular, did go a few days, and I never said anything, because I felt if this is what they felt that they needed, I wasn't going to stand in their way. I was going to let them have the edge, whichever way they could get it.
But Pat Nappy, I must tell you this. I've reported your exhortations and advices from the corner throughout these games. I lived with you when you led our team the 5 Olympic golds in Montreal. And I must say, in fairness to you, I've never heard of this before. And your advices from the corner have been specific and even motivational and inspirational.
Well, I hope so, Howard, and I hope I can continue to control the kids the same way.
Now, how much effect do you think this will have on the team's present success? Has there been a disruption of the team?
I don't believe so. Three youngsters came to me this morning early. In fact, Mark was looking for me at 2 o'clock this morning.
Breland, Tate, yes. And McCrory.
Right. And like I say, Breland was looking for me at 2 a.m. this morning to tell me that he was suckered into the play and didn't realize that this was taking place.
Well, it's a very hard time for you. You're entitled to tell your tale. Emanuel Stewart has left town. He was in so briefly, went up to Washington State for another fighter. I am sorry about what's happened, and I hope that your team continues to prove itself to the American people. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Howard.
And so an emotional Pat Nappy in the sports arena, updating the story. Coming up in a moment, Paul Gonzalez against a tough opponent.
We can make being transferred almost easy
with the Century 21 VIP Referral Network.
It means...
I'll work hard to sell your house here.
While I work hard to find your new home here.
With 6,000 offices that can help me find you buyers for your old house.
At the same time, I'm helping you find a new home across the country. You could say we work twice as hard.
Look number one to work for you.
A proud sponsor of the ABC telecasts of the 1984 Olympic Games.
It's a proud Olympic day for the athletes in L.A. And M&M's chocolate candies will be there. Those colorful candy shells they're wearing are part of all the fun and sharing. Cause the milk chocolate melts in your mouth, not in your hand.
All the world loves M&M's,
an Olympic world of fun for everyone.
M&M's chocolate candies, official snack food of the 1984 Olympics. The milk chocolate melts in your mouth, not in your hand.
Monday on ABC's World News Tonight, we'll look at air safety. Is air travel safer than a year ago?
The noise is deafening, the hue and cry in the arena. We are getting ready for a light flyweight bout between William Boganza of Uganda and Paul Gonzalez of the United States, East Los Angeles to be exact. You remember Gonzalez with his great victory over Kwang Soon Kim of South Korea. He fought almost like a professional, so skilled was his boxing then, and his punching power enormously improved. He is 20 years of age, tall for a light flyweight, 5'7 and a quarter. There is the opponent, William Boganza, who is 23. His hometown, Kampala, is a civil servant, and what we have seen of the African country fighters, they are very tough. But look at the height advantage in the tail of the tape. Though the reach advantage does not appear to be very much at all. And we get ready now for the start of the contest. And we will see, as you look at Dobrev of Bulgaria, the referee, we will see if he adheres to form. Gonzalez, of course. The judges are from West Germany, the Philippine Islands, Thailand, Colombia, and Australia. The action begins. It is Gonzalez's purpose, in his own words, to you viewers, to give all opponents a boxing lesson. The speed jab will be his principal weapon, as I've emphasized, the most important blow in Olympic scoring. Because of the frequency with which you can score, if you have possession of a good speed jab, and Gonzalez does. He is very quick-handed. He moves excellently about the ring, as you see, quick-footed too. Coming out of the barrio, the ghetto, working with a policeman named Stanky, and in the PAL, Al Stanky. He actually did it in secret, so the other guys who were developing bad habits wouldn't know what he was doing. He grew up, he said, in a fight for survival in his neighborhood. And look at that exchange. And Gonzalez is taking charge early. Astoundingly, against Kim, he floored Kim early, because we had never seen that kind of punching power from Paul. But his timing has improved enormously with his experience growing. And he is in charge so far in this round. Be assured, these African country fighters now fight with style. And Boganza got in a good right before Gonzalez answered with a combination that scored. We're into the final minute of round number one. And Begonzo, with that wild lunge that missed, left himself open. He was briefly staggered by a Gonzalez left, you may have noted. First round action, and we are counting down toward the end of the round. And Gonzalez scored very well with a right lead, and there, scored again. He is winning this round very, very big.
So special.
Family times.
Beatrice.
Friendly days.
Beatrice.
Caring.
Sharing.
Beatrice.
You've known us in so many ways.
Beatrice.
All of the times we've spent with you, we're Beatrice.
Beatrice.
Tomorrow we're gonna be there too, we're Beatrice.
Beatrice.
Knowing us.
Grown with us,
we're Beatrice.
Beatrice.
You've known us all along.
Beatrice. You might not recognize our name,
Beatrice.
But chances are you've enjoyed our products for years.
Beatrice.
And we stand behind every one, which might be the reason we've been around so long.
Beatrice.
And a pretty good reason to remember our name.
Beatrice.
We're Beatrice. You've known us all along.
Beatrice.